Week 8 is here in New Orleans. We are taking on the 1-4-1 New Orleans Saints team as we come in with a very disappointing loss to the Los Angeles Chargers, looking to bounce back, looking to get to 5-2 and really take hold of this division and not let this team back in. We'll see rookie quarterback Justin Herbert out of Oregon, and hopefully Cam and company can have another good game, but just bounce back this time with the victory. There he is, the new quarterback in New Orleans with Drew Brees now retired. We'll have to wait and see him first because we'll get on the field first here as we start. Week number 8 is underway as Dixon's going to get this in. It's going to be returnable, and he will get all the way up to the 29-yard line. So very good return there as here comes Cam in this offense. Good week last week, over 100 yards rushing for Cam. Had a pretty good passing performance as well. So hopefully we'll see how this New Orleans defense is and see if that record really holds up. 2nd and 4, Cam going to dump this one off to McCaffrey. Makes a juke move, and McCaffrey's got some room to run. He's up to the 45-yard line and a first down. So 2nd and 4 here, up to the 50 after a few plays. Cam's going to find DJ Moore. Gets a good block there from Curtis Samuel. And Moore's off to the races. He's going to get all the way down to the 5-yard line. Give him 44 yards. And just like that, we got 1st and goal and a chance to answer real early here and get on the board. So 2nd and goal from the 4. Going to hand off to McCaffrey. And there's just a bunch of Saints there. He's going nowhere. And that'll bring up a 3rd and goal here from the 9-yard line. So from the 9, Cam looking, pressure coming around the edge, getting away from Cam Jordan, but he's gonna find Henry Ruggs in the end zone for the touchdown. So great job by Cam seeing Cam Jordan coming around, and Ruggs staying put, coming down with a reception, touchdown. We take the early lead, 7-0. And here comes rookie quarterback Justin Herbert coming onto the field. We'll see how this Saints offense looks with obviously no Drew Brees, how different it's going to look. And just right off the bat, there you go. Looks like a Saints offense to me. First play of the game, 31 yards. First down up to the 44-yard line. 2nd and 10 now. Herbert's going to go to the outside. He's going to find Mike Thomas there for the catch. He's up to the 37, and it's going to bring up a 3rd and short. So going empty set, going up top 1-on-1, and it's going to be Dante Jackson almost picking that one off. Great defense there, incomplete. And they're going to try a field goal here around 54 yards. No, it's going to be a fake. And it's going to be, wow, that he might have had some guys down the field. Not sure what that was. Didn't even pass the ball. But we'll take it now. That gives us really good field position. As on 1st and 10, Cam with pressure in his face makes a great throw there to Curtis Samuel down to the 31. He's perfect so far. 5 for 5, 90 yards and a touchdown. And we're up to the 25, 2nd and 4. Ruggs with the catch, another first down down to the 19. So the offense is rolling in this game here so far. So at the 19, handoff McCaffrey, run, picks up around 5. Slow to start on the ground, but through the air, looking good. And on 3rd and 5, Cam looking, he finds Ruggs. That is just perfect timing, knowing where your receiver's going to be. Gets rid of the ball before he even breaks on the route. First down, now down to the 1-yard line, and we're going to pitch this one to McCaffrey. Nice block by Thomas is going to get McCaffrey into the end zone. Touchdown, and we're really responding to this ball game. 2 big touchdowns to start off, 14-0 lead, and can we get a stop right coming right back defensively? 1st and 10, Herbert looking right over the defender's head. That's going to be caught. That's going to be a first down and up to the 44-yard line by Jared Cook. So from the 44, 1st and 10, going to Kamara on the ground. He is going to get maybe around 5 as Eric Reed comes down, makes that tackle. And it's going to bring up a 3rd and 1 here. So let's see if they go to the ground or the air. As Herbert, they're going to go to the air here. He's looking. Pass is going to be dropped, incomplete. There's a flag on the play. It's going to be holding on the offense. So we'll decline that penalty. Make them go for it. They won't. They'll punt. And now we have a chance to really take a huge lead here. As we got 2 minutes left here in this first quarter. McCaffrey with the catch there. That picks up around 9. And we have a 3rd and 1 now. We go to Gus Edwards on the ground. Gus has plenty of room to run. Picks himself up 10 yards. First down. And we're up to the 47-yard line. So we'll keep Gus in the backfield. Give him the ball again. Nice blocking there to allow him to pick up around 8 yards there. He'll give him 9. We'll keep him on the keep him in the ball game and let him run once more, get another first down. It's a nice little three-play effort there from Gus Edwards. And we're now into the second quarter. Drive still going here. They bring a full-out blitz. It's picked up, and we got Greg Olsen there just open underneath. And, man, that was a great job of the offensive line. I think they brought 6 or 7 guys. You picked it up, first down, and now we're driving it here again as McCaffrey has a room to run, picks up 18 yards. He's all the way down to the 1 yard line, his best run of the ball game. Chance now to put this up to a 3-touchdown lead. We give it to McCaffrey, and McCaffrey's going to get in for the score. Maybe a little help from DeMario Davis, but we will take it, and man, this is the best we have looked here this season. 21-0. Here in the second quarter, and maybe that 4-1 record is something for the Saints team, as now Brian Burns gets in there bringing down Herbert for the sack. And just like that, they have a third down, 3rd and 20, and they are reeling here. So the catch underneath, but that's going to be nowhere near enough, and they're not going to give their defense any breaks as they just go 3 and out, punt the ball, and here comes Cam and company. So far, so good, 3 of 3 on drives. As 1st and 10, he had his receiver. First bad pass of the game here for Cam. That's going to be incomplete. So we got a 3rd and 10. Looking, 4-man rush goes underneath, and there we go. Wide open is Curtis Samuel. Just going through his progressions was Cam. Going from left to right, finding Samuel. 1st down up to the 44-yard line as we're near halfway here through the second quarter. As this time the blitz finally gets to him as Cam Jordan gets in there. First sack of the game here for the Saints team, and it's going to bring up a 3rd and long. So this time they just drop back into coverage, and Cam this time once again, perfect timing with his receiver, DJ Moore this time, 1st down to the 44, and man, if we can put this to a 4-touchdown game, we would almost put this one out of reach just like that, as Cam gets through, off the pressure, slides through, we'll see where they give him the spot, just a tad short. So we'll bring Jordan Scarlett this time in for the run, and he gets good blocking. 1st down, and Moore takes off with that speed, that acceleration there. Picks up 13 yards up to the 22-yard line, and man, we have just absolutely controlled this whole first half. 3rd and 8, though. Cam looking around, trying to find something. Going to try to find DJ Moore, and his arm was grabbed. I could almost say that was interference, no flag. So that's where the drive will stall. We'll kick a field goal, but once again, more points, and we're up 24-0 here with 3 minutes left in this first half, and this Saints offense really needs to get going, because if they do not, I mean, this game is going to be over before they know it. So 2nd and 5, Herbert is going to go underneath there to Cook. 1st down. He's up to the 41-yard line. So it looks like maybe Herbert's getting into a bit of a rhythm. It's going to find Kamara on the outside. Nice tackle there by Jackson, not allowing him to break through because nobody else was there. As we got 1:30 left, so the Saints looking for their first points of this ball game. As Kamara with another catch picks himself up 10. You know, they haven't really ran the ball much with him. They really haven't had a shot, so at least got to get him involved somehow. 3 catches so far. Number 45 seconds, they're looking for a touchdown. They need a touchdown. I mean, a field goal would help them out, but touchdown is really what the Saints team needs to get from the 1. Play action does not work out as Simmons comes through for the sack. And now it's going to bring up a 3rd and goal here from the 8-yard line with 22 seconds left. Herbert looking from the gun. He is looking around. He's going to go up top. Pretty much just a throwaway. Incomplete. So New Orleans there is going to set up a field goal here to just get on the board before halftime. The kick is up. It is good. 24-3 to score as we head into halftime. And an absolute dominating performance by this Panthers team. Best we have looked so far, I'd have to say, this season. Cam looking on point. Running game's been slow, but when you're passing so well and the defense really working out, it does not really matter. As we head down to Tampa Bay, this is a big game. Tampa Bay at 4-3, Falcons at 3-3. Both teams, I believe, lost last week, and right now trying to get back on schedule. This will be for second place there, and you know, obviously with us losing last week, that's, you know, these teams still around. So obviously, right now we're looking in control. So that's a really important game as the Browns right now up 14-0 over the Steelers. Browns looking for their 4th win of the season. We head up to Minnesota, Houston, and the Vikings. Two more disappointing teams. Texans is 2-4. Vikings at 2-5. Right now, the Texans with the lead. But you're expecting a lot better from those teams. And it's just like, I have to say, a lot of these teams right now this season, very disappointing. Especially the Saints team. I know they got a rookie quarterback, but their defense is good. They have a solid, you know, offense with, you know, one of the best receivers in Thomas Kamara, but really, they just cannot get it done. As you can see, that's going to be a drop pass incomplete, and they go three and out right off the bat. So now we have a chance with this offense to get it going here. So we're going to do a little pitch pass there to Henry Ruggs, and it works out perfectly. First down up to the 36, give him 17 yards. And now Cam 14 and 18, seventh catch there for Ruggs in this ball game. So first and 10, handoff to McCaffrey, run and more, first down up to the 49. So maybe, if we get this run game going, the Saints can absolutely forget about it. They at least had that where they've shut us down through the run. So first and 10 from the 49. Cam looking, watch out, pressure coming. That's a one way to slow us down. Sack right up the middle. Onyemata comes through for the sack. But I have to say, it's only the second sack of the ball game for New Orleans. It's not like they've gotten so much pressure on us. Cam's just been allowed to sit back there. So great job by the offensive line. And really, even if you're sitting back there, nice job by Cam making the throws. But that's going to end that drive there, the sack. We just threw a screen there to McCaffrey. Punt the ball. So that's the first drive of the ball game where we do not come away with a score. And that opens up this game to a New Orleans. So if you can get a touchdown here, if you're the Saints, it's only a two-touchdown game, and you got plenty of time left. But you need to get that drive going. And that's a good way to start with Kamara. That's only his fifth carry of the ball game. So he's up to the 47-yard line. And that's going to be a first down. But another third down here, third and two, and that's where it runs at. Luke Kuechly gets through. Simmons was there as well. Sack back to the 46-yard line. So just when you think the Saints team is going to get something going, does not happen. Our defense steps up, punt the ball. But right now you can see third and 24. This Saints team might get the ball right back as maybe their defense is starting to step up, gets the second stop of this half against their offense, and allows them to give them good field position. So here we go. Really good field position. Best of the game for the Saints offense. We'll see what they can do. But can our defense make a stop? And just like that, they have a third down. So third and six. Herbert looking to the outside, and it's going to be caught. First down. And exactly what this Saints offense needed. So they're up to the 39-yard line. First and 10. Going to pitch it there to Kamara, but the outside is covered by Delpit and Eric Reed there on the stop. That's going to be a loss of three, maybe knocking them out of field goal range. And it's going to bring up a third and 9. So Herbert on the play action, looking in the pocket, and it's almost picked off. Eric Reed knocks it away. Incomplete. So let's see if they actually try the field goal this time instead of the fake. 55-yarder. The kick is up, has plenty of distance, but it's going to be wide left. Will Lutz cannot make that one there. No good. And now gives our offense, which has been sputtering a little bit here in the second half, great field position. But that is a perfect start as DJ Moore just burnt Williams there up to the 19-yard line. First down. And now looking for maybe that touchdown here to put this one away here with 1 minute left in this third quarter. We'll dump it down to Ian Thomas. Thomas dives forward, and he's in for the score. Nice job by Cam, just getting rid of it just in time before getting hit. Thomas makes the play, touchdown, putting this game up to 31-3 here with 40 seconds left in this third quarter. I would say this ball game is probably just about over. Dominating performance here. We'll just have to obviously try to finish this one off. Would love to not allow this New Orleans team in the end zone. So third and one, they get the first down underneath. As we head in here now to the fourth quarter, as Jared Cook comes with a catch up to the 42-yard line. Second and 10, Herbert underneath. Oh, that's going to be dropped, incomplete. So sometimes his receiver's not really helping him out in this ball game. As it brings up a third down, pressure in his face as it get rid of it. And there is a Kuechly there to push down the receiver. Maybe another drop pass, incomplete. And they're going to go for it here. Fourth and 10, they have no choice. Down 31-3. They miss it here. That really going to really be the ball game. That's going to go up top one-on-one coverage, but knocked away from Fuller. Knocks that one away. Nice play there by the defender and sets us up at the 42-yard line. And now looking to really just put this game away as McCaffrey going to be stopped there. You can see only 15 carries for 51 yards. Does have the two touchdowns. And it's going to bring up a 3rd and 7. He's just going to run a QB draw. And it works out perfectly for Cam. Right up the middle. Nobody there. Linebackers drop back. First down. Drive continues here at the 30-yard line. And this time we'll go to Scarlett on the ground, who picks himself up 11 yards. And another first down to continue this and just continue to take some time off here. Another third down. This time we'll go to McCaffrey. And McCaffrey's going to have plenty of room to run. Goes in for the touchdown. Puts this up to 38-3 score. And that's going to pretty much be your ball game. What a dominating performance here in New Orleans for this Panthers team. Man, that was one of the best games we have played for sure. And if we could see this team really all season, even though I have to say maybe the record works out for the New Orleans team because they just did not look good at all. But really, good dominating performance. They did get another field goal, but 41-6 is your final score. Actually holding them under 300 yards of offense, which really sometimes is pretty good. Cam, another good game. He's stacking these good games up, which is great. 19-23, 241, two touchdowns. McCaffrey only 3.8 yards a carry, but we'll take the three touchdowns. Can't really complain with that. Edwards and Scarlett had pretty good for only having three carries. Ruggs with the 7 catches. You know, didn't need a whole lot. DJ Moore with a good, huge gain there. 94 yards receiving, only 3 catches. And the defense really shut down this offense. I mean, they didn't really get Kamara involved, which I thought for sure they would probably do. I thought they would, but they didn't. Only 8 carries. I think he might have had around, he had 5 catches, but only for 29 yards. You can see there's a lot of drops from the New Orleans receivers, but dominating performance, great victory, and we get back on track, and we head up to, we get 5-2 now, the record of the season, and I think Green Bay is next, as Carter Coughlin, still getting close to see what he's going to be development-wise, if he'll be a star, one awareness, you see what he plays he's got left, to 234 to 500, not sure if we'll reach that this season. You know, we were trying to reach him in there, maybe, we'll see. As we got a bunch of, got two backup linemen here. Larson, we'll just work on the pass pro there. Let's see what he gets here. 3 pass block, 2 pass block for Ness. Just in case his linemen go down. You know, I wouldn't really rely on any of these guys here, but, you know, you can't. It's just so, it's one of the positions that guys have, you know, GMs have had a hard time finding really in the NFL is really linemen. It's tough. So, you know, any depth you can have is what we need. As you can see, the Buccaneers ended up beating the Falcons. So the Bucs at 5-3, just a game behind us. As the Falcons now move to 3-4. We take on the Packers, who are 5-2 as well. They've won 2 straight right there with the Bears at 5-2. So let's take a look also. I guess we can go around all the other divisions. So this will be a good game. Even though, look at the Packers. -7 in the point differential, yet they have a 5-2 record. So that's interesting. So we go to around the other divisions. AFC North, Ravens lead at 5-2. Browns sitting there at 4-4 that have won 3 straight. South, the Colts at 6-2. Texans at 3-4. Jaguars at 3-5. And the 1-6 Titans. Patriots at 5-2. Jets at 4-3 have lost 2 in a row. Dolphins at 3-4 still sitting in there. And in the West, the Chargers at 6-2. Chiefs 5-2-1 with the Broncos at 4-3. Raiders 3-4. Pretty much still in the wild card. We saw a division there. We saw our division. Cowboys at 6-2. Giants at 5-2. Eagles have won 2 straight. So, you know, we saw the 1 week where they hadn't get a victory yet, but they won 2 in a row, trying to stay around. And the Seahawks at 6-1 with the Niners at 5-2. So there is your standings. Another thing was Trey Smith. We found his development. He is a star development. So can't really complain about that as we got him in the later rounds and he turns into our starting left tackle star development. So that is good to see. Still have to work on him. He only has 72 run block. You know, obviously 74 lead block. Got to work on that. Pass block, finesse 66. Got to work on that. And Jarek Willis Jr. is going to be a star development as well. So we got star development all across the offensive line. He's obviously a little better. Got to work on that run block power for sure, but still, he's pretty good. Grant Delpit, we're just a tad short, just about 45 plays away to seeing what he will be. Will he be a superstar X factor? Will he just be a superstar? I'm not sure. We'll see what happens with Grant Delpit, but that's going to be probably maybe next game. We'll see. As we head into Green Bay, we take on Aaron Rodgers in this Green Bay offense, 5-2. Another tough test, this time on the road. Before we really, you know, look down the schedule again, Denver's a good team. Tampa Bay's having a great season. And then we go to Chicago and then Minnesota. Man, it just doesn't stop this season, as it's going to be a tough stretch even to get into the playoffs. But that's going to do it for this one. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you please leave a like, comment, subscribe. I will see you in the next one. You guys have a good one. Bye-bye.